everyone. We're going to start very shortly. Today. Welcome everyone. Hope you all had a great and lovely, it's getting real close. Hope you all had a great and lovely weekend. Hi, my name is Ayo, and today we're going to be scheduling or going through our stretch routine. So, as usual, all you'll need today is a mat and some space, and then we're gonna get started on our stretches. Alright, so here's what we're gonna do. First of all, let me zoom out a little. We're gonna start with the lower body, and then we're gonna work our way up towards our upper body torso. Alright, so the first position that we're gonna go over today is the, let's make it nice and simple. Let me just set my timer. We're gonna go into a child's pose. Alright. So we're going to sit back. Let me actually adjust this timer here. Add an additional 10 seconds to it. Alright, so with the child's pose, all we're doing is in the quadruped position, leaning forward, dropping that torso down. I'm just trying to inch forward with our hands here. I'm going to feel a stretch in the back here. It's important to focus on your breathing. Remember, we're also going to be holding these positions for about 60 seconds here. So try as much as you can to relax. We got 20 more seconds left in this particular position. Alright, 5 seconds. Excellent. Alright, and then from here, what we're going to go into is the cobra. So we're going to lay flat onto our stomach, use that hand, push the torso up and off the floor here. This one you're going to feel along the abdomen. Hopefully I can see the full shot. Yes, you can. So the next one we're going to go into is the pigeon pose. So we're going to be working on the glute. We're going to bring that right leg forward. We'll bring the left leg forward. And then we're going to drop the torso down as far as you can. Alright. Dropping that torso down as low as you can comfortably. And again, we're going to be feeling this along the glute. Hold for another 60 seconds here, total time.
controlling your breathing through your nose, exhaling out through your mouth. Excellent. All right, so we're going to go ahead and switch sides. So we're going to bring that right leg forward. And again, we're going to hold for time here. Should be feeling this again along the glute. Should be where you should be. That is where you should be primarily. Of the tension in for this stretch. Nicely done, everyone. So again, we're going to slowly come out of this, and we're going to transition into the half split. All right, so we're going to be focusing on our hamstrings. So you're going to come down, extend the right leg out like so, right? And then from here, we're going to drop the hands down as low as we can comfortably. So for me, I'm feeling pretty tight today. So instead of being on the floor, I'm going to have my hands on the side. Just gonna slightly drop my torso down. I'm gonna get a nice stretch in the back of my leg since it's very, very tight for me today. Of course, if you feel that you have the mobility, you can by all means try and reach for the floor here. Let's go ahead and switch our legs. So we're going to do that left leg now. Extending. And then reaching down to the floor. Going to get a stretch. Again, we're focusing on the hamstring here. Let me adjust this camera angle. Make it a little wider. So again, focusing on that hamstring. All right. Excellent. All right, let's go ahead and switch our legs once more. And then from here, what we're going to go into is a hip flexor stretch. So what you're going to do in a kneeling lunge position like so, right? You're going to go ahead and squeeze this right glute, right? Make sure you squeeze it. Think about driving the hips a little forward like so. And then you're going to feel a nice long stretch along the hip flexor here.
in the front of the leg, and we're gonna hold for time here. All right. So let's go ahead and switch our legs here. So we're going to be switching our legs, driving those hips forward, squeezing the glute, and holding for time. Fantastic. Nice work, everyone. So the next one we're going to go into is the 90-90 stretch. So getting 90 degrees with the front leg, 90 degrees with the back leg. All right. So 90 degrees here, 90 degrees here. All right. And then we're just going to hold this position for time. Try and keep this upright with your torso. And then also have a slight lean back. That way we can get a little bit of a stretch in this internal hip rotator. So here we go. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and switch our legs. Alright. Alright, and we're just gonna hold for time. Awesome. Nicely done. Nicely done. Excellent work. Slowly come out of it. Very slowly. Good stuff, everyone. So the next one we're going to go into, we're going to go into some, one of my favorite exercises, which is the frog position, all right? So we're going to open up our legs. Let me adjust the angle here. So we're going to open up our hips or our legs as wide as we can, comfortably. And then from here, we're going to set our torso down onto the floor. And what we're going to do here, we're going to try and push the hips back as far as we can comfortably, right? But keeping the knees as wide as we can, and also making sure that the ankles are in line with the knees while we're in this position. Here we're going to be focusing on the groin here. So we're trying to open up the adductors, the groin area, and the hips, all right? So once you get into your position, this is going to be very uncomfortable for some people. I know for me, for a fact. You're going to try and push those hips back as far back as you can comfortably. You're going to try your best to relax in this position. Just going to hold for time. See, I really struggle with this stretch here. Oh, oh boy. All right. Very difficult stretch for me, but very good in opening up the hips here. All right. So this next stretch that we're going to go into, just my ankle once more, we're going to sit in a saddle position like so. That way we get a nice little stretch in our quadriceps and in back of the ankle. And for this one, we're going to focus on, our shoulders. So what we're going to do, we're going to take the right arm, bring it across the shoulder like so, and hold. Alright, and let's go ahead and switch sides. So shake it out a little. Let's go ahead and do the opposite side here. Awesome. So the next one we're going to go into, just a few more stretches. We're going to go into a thread the needle. So we're going to be in a quadruped position, like so. I'll actually do it facing this angle. We're going to take the left arm, fiddle it in between the gap of the right hand and the right knee. And we're just going to drop the torso down. And we're just going to hold for time here. This one you should feel along the rhomboids and in the upper back. A little in the shoulder as well. And then let's go ahead and switch sides. Alrighty, last stretch for today, really last one. I'm going to hit back into that saddle position. And then from here, what we're going to do, we're just going to adjust the neck. I'm going to pull that head down. And while we're pulling the neck down, gently, very gently, I'm going to be depressing this opposite shoulder blade. Go ahead and switch sides. Alrighty, shake it out. Slowly come out of it. And just like that, you're all set. So that's going to be pretty much it for today's stretching session. Hopefully you all enjoyed that. Hopefully it was nice and relaxing. Able to open up and get a little bit loose in our body. Let me get in a little closer to you. So hopefully that was a nice relaxing session. And if you're interested in more, feel free. Shoot us a message on our Instagram page. Oh, I'm not in the shot. Shoot us a message on the Instagram page if you're ever interested in booking a free fitness consultation. And we'll be more than happy to assist you in your fitness journey. All right. Thank you so much for joining me today. This is Io signing out. Oh, that looks kind of funny. Oh, God. That's kind of funny.